Well, good morning, Bisons. Welcome to the gathering. Yeah. Oh, it's going to be a fun morning together. I'm so glad that you're here as you're getting settled this morning. Hey, let me just invite you. If you've got some space in the middle of your road, do the kind neighborly thing. Try to scoot to the middle of your road and make some room on the edges for people who are still walking in, trying to find a place to sit this morning. We got a full house. It's like there's something special happening this morning. I don't know what's going on. We do. We've got For King and Country in the house here in just a little bit. We're excited about that, but let me tell you about a few things that are happening. As you're getting settled this morning, we do want to take just a second to make sure that we are being kind and welcoming, a hospitable community. So take a second to turn around, look at the folks around you, look them in the eye, and tell them, I'm so glad that you're here. Make sure you turn all directions in front of you, behind you, to the left, to the right. I'm so glad you're here.
Thank you.
If you say it enough, maybe someone will make a sticker about you. I hear that sometimes happens. All right, let me tell you about a few things that are happening on campus, and then we're going to get on with our show today. If you don't know already, this week is Inclusion Awareness Week, and there are all kinds of things happening as we try to be an inclusive community that's sponsored by the Office of Accessibility, by ABLE, the student organization, and by SGA. You can look at the list of all those kinds of opportunities. Again, as we try to just be a community that is inclusive of all members of God's world and of God's people. So find ways to get plugged in with Inclusion Awareness Week. If you want to study abroad and you have not yet signed up for the fall, I can tell you it's an incredible, life-changing, transformative experience. There are spots available for Lipscomb and Florence for 2024. If you want to know more about that, if you're interested, please email globallearning@lipscomb.edu. There are so many things happening. We have an exciting weekend ahead. We're getting ready for Wild Bison Fest on Saturday. Let's hear a little bit more about that. Come up on stage, guys, and tell us a little bit more about Wild Bison happening on Saturday on campus. Let's give them a hand.
Thanks, guys. So this Saturday is Wild Bison Music and Arts Festival, which we're super excited about, and all of you should come. It's free to attend, and it's from noon to 8. It's a come-and-go event, so you can pop by, and there will be stuff all over the square.
Yeah, you're not going to want to miss this weekend. We've got 8 hours straight of music, art, food, dancing, crafts. There's literally like no reason that you would not want to be here. Bring your friends, bring your families if they're close. It's going to be a great weekend, and we hope to see you there.
Thanks so much, guys. Come out on Saturday. 8 hours of activities for Wild Bison Fest. We told you about SGA elections before spring break. Oh, yeah. Spring break just happened. Did you have a good spring break? Yeah, thank goodness. I feel so much better after spring break. SGA elections are right on the horizon. If you're interested in running for SGA Senate, make sure that you know you've got to go to one of these interest meetings before you sign up to run. So make sure that you go to one of those interest meetings. Campaign season will be at the beginning of April. Election day is on April 9th and on April 11th. So make sure you pay attention to Have You Heard for more information about SGA elections. Next week is a big week on our campus as we turn our minds to Easter. Next week is what the Christian world calls Holy Week. And it is a season where we focus on, we commemorate the life, death, and resurrection of Jesus as we look to Sunday, as we look to Easter. So there are all kinds of activities happening throughout the week with Holy Week. You're going to hear from our office all throughout the week, every single day, with different events and program and activities, devotionals, all kinds of resources as we collectively as a community focus our minds and hearts on the life, death, and resurrection of Jesus. Let me point out a few things that are happening. On Sunday, we kick things off with a worship night at 8 o'clock in Shamblin Theater. We'd love to see you there in Shamblin at 8 o'clock for our Palm Sunday worship night. Right after that, we'll be out in the square with some bonfires, hanging out, making s'mores, spending some time together. We'll also kick off our communal art project in the Student Center. We'll also kick off a service project in the Student Center, so make sure you come and join on Sunday night for all those things. On Monday, we've got a Stations of the Cross service in Ezell Chapel. And then on Tuesday, a week from today, you'll want to make sure and be back in the gathering for number one New York Times bestselling novelist Karen Kingsbury. She'll be sharing with us, and we'll be led in worship by Christy and Nathan Knuckles, who were the original, like part of the original Passion Conference band. They're worship leaders, they're musicians, they're award-winning, they're wild, and they're going to be leading worship for us in the gathering. Karen Kingsbury is going to share a word with us. Make sure that you're here on Tuesday for all of that. Today on campus, you've got a unique opportunity to be a part of something really, really special, a way to love and serve the people around you in a really unique way. And to tell us a little bit more about that, I would like for you to put your hands together for Jeannie Smith from Earl Young's team. Jeannie, tell us more about what's happening today.
First of all, thanks for letting us be at Lipscomb today. I bring greetings from Searcy, Arkansas, to all the Searcy kids. You know who you are. Come see me today if you know who I am already. But I am with Earl Young's team, and our mission is to help save lives. And our primary focus is to help get college and university students across the country registered as a potential bone marrow or blood stem cell donor on the national registry. So what does that really mean? Well, you go to the swabbing stations that we have today in the Student Center. We'll be there until 2:00 today. And tomorrow we'll be in the pharmacy building, the Burton Center for Health Sciences, from 1 to 4. But what the process looks like, takes about 5 or 6 minutes to swab the inside of your cheeks. Your DNA basically gets typed and put into the National Registry. And you might get a call in 2 weeks, 2 months, 20 years, who knows? You might get a call to save a life for someone with leukemia, sickle cell disease, or 70 other blood disorders. So our mission at Earl Young's team is, again, to go around to college campuses. We love coming to faith-based schools because the heart and soul of Jesus is to save lives. And so we feel like that's kind of an extension of the work from Jesus Ministry into the work that we do at Earl Young's team. We've been at Lipscomb. It's been pre-pandemic. I'm not sure any of you were here at the time, but we have a network of schools across the country, and our faith-based schools are really our favorite places to go because you kind of just inherently get the concept of saving a life. So stop by today until 2 in the Student Center, tomorrow from 1 to 4 in the pharmacy building. Get swabbed to save a life.
That's awesome. Jeannie, thank you so much for the work that you're doing. Make sure that you go and get swabbed for Earl Young team. We're going to skip that video, team. We're just going to move on because we've got too many exciting things happening today. I think you're going to want to get on your feet for this, though, because today we've got For King and Country in the house. 4-time Grammy Award-winning Christian music duo, 11 number one songs, 2 billion career streams? I mean, come on. And don't forget that tonight, you can see a pre-release screening of their new movie, Unsung Hero. They're going to talk about that. We're going to see the trailer here in a minute. But at 5:00 tonight in Shamlin Theater, you can get an exclusive pre-release screening, and you can hear a conversation about the movie. They're going to play some of their music. They're also going to have a conversation with Steve Taylor, who's a professor in the College of Entertainment and the Arts and is a friend of the Smallbones. But I'm just wasting my time. Are you guys ready? Let's put our hands together for King and Country.
Top of the morning, Lipscomb University. Sing along.
Stand face to face with a younger me. No, yeah. All of the mistakes, all of the heartbreak, here's what I do differently.
If you're with us this morning, let me hear you give a cheer. I love like you must give when it's nothing. Speak out for freedom. everybody knows it, everybody knows it.
Oh, but the less travel is hard to walk.
Everybody knows it.
It takes a soldier.
Every voice.
I'll fix my
Well, it's lovely to be back with you. Are you awake? Well, this song talks about a beautiful thing, to be loved right as we are, right where we are, no matter who we are. Take it away, little brother.
I am a little unstable, loose wires always get entangled now. I am a little bit difficult, I can be a little self-critical now. It's amazing that you care. Love me like I am. And even when I can't, you still love me as I am. Oh, I don't know how you do it. And I know I put you through it. Yeah, it's amazing that you care. Oh, love me like I. Love me like I. You're nothing short of a miracle now. Oh, somehow you're still with me. It's amazing that you care. Love me like I am. And even when I can't, you still love me as I am. Oh, I don't know how you do it. And I know I put you through it. Yeah, it's amazing that you care. Love me like I. Oh, you love me like I. Oh,
We're going to let that truth sink deep into our souls. So we're going to sing You Love Me Like I, and then you shout M after us like this.
You love me like I.
Oh, that's good. You've got more in you. Come on.
You love me like I.
All the fellas after Luke.
You love me like I.
Ladies after me.
You love me like I.
All together loud and proud, shout it out.
You love me like I.
One last time for the morning.
You love me like I. It's amazing that you can love me like I am. And even when I can't, yeah, you still love me as I am. Oh, I don't know how you do it, and I know I put you through it. Yeah, it's amazing that you can love me like I love me. It's amazing that you can. Love is like we, love is like we.
And I know that we all walk into this room in different places in life. Some of us are finding love. Congratulations. Some of you are facing loss. Some of you walk in with such deep sorrow, others with such beautiful joy. What I love about God is there's room for us all right where you are. Wide awake while the world is sound asleep, too afraid of what might show up while you're dreaming. Nobody, nobody, nobody sees you. Nobody, nobody will believe you. Every day you try to pick up all the pieces, all the memories, they somehow never leave you. Nobody, nobody, nobody sees you. Nobody, nobody will believe you. God only knows what you've been through. God only knows what they say about you. God only knows how it's killing you. There's a kind of love that God only knows.
God only knows what you've been. God only knows what they say about you. God only knows the real you. There's a kind of love that God only knows. There's a kind of love that there's a kind of love. You keep a cover over every single secret. So afraid of someone so them they would leave you.
But somebody, somebody, somebody sees you. Somebody, somebody will never leave you. Come on, come on.
God only knows what you've been through. God only knows what they say about you. God only knows how it's killing you.
Come on.
But there's a kind of love that
God only knows.
God only knows what you've been through. God only knows what they say about you. God only knows the real you. But there's a kind of love. Understood and the ones to blame. What if we could start over? We could start over. We could start over. No, for the lonely, for the ashamed, the misunderstood and the ones to blame. What if we could start over? We could start over. We could start over. There's a kind of love that God only knows. God only knows what you've been through. Love it, God only knows. God only knows. kind of love they got on them.
Would you give a cheer for the Fakir Country Band acoustic style? You may have a seat, rest your weary legs. Hey, raise your hand and make some noise if you've joined us at a Fakir Country show. Where am I, Fakir Country? It's come on. I see you. Raise your hand and make some noise if it's your first time ever with us right now. Raise your hand and make some noise if you're really confused by our accents. Thank you. We are originally from Australia, but we live right here in good old Nashville, Tennessee now, y'all. Can I get a yee-haw? Lipscomb's good at the yee-haw. Congratulations. And we feel like this is one of our home colleges. My wife is a Lipscomb alumni. True story. There's something you didn't know. And Luke, I live in Franklin. Luke lives halfway to Alabama in Columbia, just down the road. And we love it here. We made a home here. We are from Australia, but we became American citizens a little while ago. We married Americans. Luke has 4 half-American children, everyone. And I'll say this is really special because we were just recapping with Steve backstage. Virtually every major moment that we've had as musicians, we have had some kind of Lipscomb celebration. When we released Burn the Ships, we were here. When we released our first film, Priceless, we were here. Most of you weren't here, but nonetheless, we were here. And speaking of movies, we, as it was mentioned, we've been working on a feature film that circles around a family or a mum. A mom. How do you say it? You sound like a little herd of sheep. So nice. Circles around a mom and taking her 6 kids and moving halfway around the world from Australia to the United States. It's a 90s film. It's actually our parents' origin story of coming over here and all the triumphs and tragedies they faced along the way. Our dad is actually here today too, everyone. He's here somewhere. And we worked on it in 2022. Luke had the idea of putting it together in 2020, and we're going to share more about it later. But it's obviously a film that's very close to our hearts. And speaking of our dad, I play my dad in the film, which I've dubbed a very expensive therapy session. He's heard me say it. But it was a beautiful process. And we'd love to, if we may... We'd love to show you a clip from the movie. Or a trailer. What about a trailer from the movie? Take a look at the screens, everyone. This is a little sneak peek of Unsung Hero.
Okay, stay close. Let's go.
How y'all doing?
Are y'all from England?
Australia. Australia. Wish I had an accent.
Dad, I wrote a song. Thought maybe we could ask for an audition.
Oh, that's great, honey. Let's take it one step at a time. Okay, tells me you're a promoter. You know someone looking for one. Well, I may know somebody who should be.
She's been given a beautiful voice. It's a miracle.
She's a special one, son. Your family, they're not in the way. They are the way.
There's no food. We're almost out of money. We need to make some changes. Kids, we need your help. This is everything we have. And sometimes it's going to grow, and sometimes it will shrink. But it cannot be allowed to disappear. I wonder if she's right. Maybe I'm not meant to sing. Or maybe you're not meant to sing other people's songs. It's going to be dangerous and scary. And giving up, giving in, it's not an option. Whatever your dream is, I know you can achieve it.
Please welcome my big sister.
My dream is to be like you. It always has been.
Thank you kindly. Hey, if you're thinking of your mum this morning, I encourage you to send her a text or tell her that you love her for all the sacrifice, the sleepless nights, all the prayers, the ways that she showed that she cared. None of us would be here if it weren't for our parents. This is Unsung Hero, the song.
Once upon a time, you were 25. Walking up the aisle, you made the promise of your life. You blinked twice and you were 29, singing lullabies. And I looked up at you for the first time. Words fall short, but I am sure they'll never. I was 21 and I fell in love. Remember how I told you that I'd search the world? Yeah, I found a girl, and oh, how she reminds me of you. You're strong like your father. You love like your mother, like there's nothing to lose. You're a lonesome hero, and I sing this song for you. For all the times I fell down, you showed me how. And when we crossed the ocean, you were my safe place to land. Been on a thousand stages, but when it's all said and done, oh, I hope I make you proud of the man that I've become.
To be strong like my father, even when I'm scared. And when someone's in trouble, oh, I'll never leave them there. And I love like my mother, like there's nothing to lose. You're our unsung heroes, and we sing this song for you.
All right. I'm Steve Taylor. I'm the director of the School of Theater and Cinematic Arts, and I'm so happy to be with my friends.
We should sit closer, shouldn't we, Steve? We should sit closer.
What do you say,
there
right here?
There we go. All right.
So, most of you wouldn't know this, but I've known Joel and Luke since they were, like, tiny little things.
Tiny little tots.
Tiny little tots. Yeah. Their dad, David Smallbone, is the movie shows as a promoter in Australia, and he actually brought my band over in the late 80s to do some shows in Australia, and we had a barbecue at his house, at your house, which is such a cliche, a barbecue in Australia.
A Barbie.
You call it. And you were all running around, and your older brother, Daniel, I think, was the one I made the closest connection with because he liked the rock music, and he's, as far as I'm concerned, still the one with the best taste in your family. But
do you guys know what Steve, like, Steve was an artist, very successful artist. You should go on YouTube some of the live performances.
That's not necessarily a good idea.
You may have more or less respect. I don't know. But you should Google.
He even got the lyrics Captain Crunch into a song. Yeah,
well, that's right.
The cereal.
Yes.
We're all doing what we can to make a living. Right. So, Luke, tell us about the origin of this movie.
Yeah, yeah. So, as Joel mentioned, originally born in Australia. Hopefully you can still tell. The truth is you Americans have jacked up my accent. Thanks. All right. Born in Australia, our dad was a concert promoter, as you mentioned, in Australia. And on one particular tour that he brought back, it wasn't Steve's tour, the tour didn't go very well. And we actually ended up losing everything that we had as a family. We lost the house, we lost the car, we lost the life savings. And so dad was looking for a fresh start for his career, for the family. And he got a job offer right here in Nashville, Tennessee. And he thought it would be a good idea to move his six kids and his wife, who was 6 months pregnant at the time, to the other side of the world. But as soon as we arrived in America, my dad actually lost that job. And so we're straight on the other side of the world, no friends, no family. We were sleeping on beds made out of clothes. I didn't have any way for our little sister to be born in a hospital. I weren't always quite sure where the next meal was going to come from. We really, really struggled as a family when we first came here. And I've told kind of some semblance of that story at virtually every Fakir and Country performance over the last 10 or 11 years. And I've had folks come up to us and say, man, you guys should write a book. It's a fascinating story. And the truth is, Joel and I were homeschooled, and so we don't read or write very well. And we didn't
shout
go to Lipscomb.
Shout out to the homeschoolers. I got you. Yeah.
That's right. That's right. You guys did much better than us. You got accepted to Lipscomb. Bravo. But I often joke. It's like, man, we can't write books. But what if we were to write? What if we were to make a movie instead? And I went to a producer friend of mine in LA a number of years ago, kind of pitched him the idea. And look, the whole idea is this. I think family is more important in today's day and age than it ever has been in the history of the world, yet we do not value it as such. Mother Teresa says, if you want to change the world, go home and love your family. And that's essentially what this movie kind of is all about, kind of the thesis behind it.
Joel, you actually co-wrote the movie?
Yes.
And co-directed the movie?
Yeah,
and
just
then
trying
you
to be like you.
Star is your father in the movie.
Right.
And so, as you know, Lipscomb is a university, and it's actually a research
We're not that
university.
Dumb, Steve. We're not
I
that
know.
Dumb. All right.
So, because we're a Lipscomb University research classification, we actually did some research. And what we researched is I wanted to find out if there's ever been a situation where an actor has played his own father in a movie. And it turns out that there are two examples that I could find. Do we have those up there? Can we see those? The first one is it Shea Jackson Jr.?
Wow.
Stars as Ice Cube in the movie Straight Outta Compton. Did you know that? He actually played
I missed that one.
His own father.
I thought that was inspiration, to be honest.
Yeah. Yes. And then the second one was not a movie, it was a TV series where...
You missed one, Steve, in all your research.
What was that one? Well, because this one is Dwayne The Rock Johnson plays his wrestler father in the TV series That 70s Show.
I'll give you a third one.
Okay, I'm ready.
Shia LaBeouf plays his dad in a film called
you know
Honey
what?
Boy.
I did know that and I forgot it.
Yeah.
But
okay. It's a research.
Research seems to be going very well here at Lipscomb, Steve.
Sorry. Well, I was going for two of the ones that were a little less crazy than Shia LaBeouf, but that's just so following the footsteps of Ice Cube, Shia LaBeouf, and Dwayne The Rock Johnson. I mean, can you all smell what the Joel is cooking here? That's impressive.
I was specifically thinking of Dwayne Johnson when I did this.
Good job. We can't wait to see it. So tell us what you hope an audience takes away from the movie, by the way, which we are showing tonight on campus at Shamblin Theater at 5 o'clock. So make sure to RSVP. I can't wait to see you all there. It's going to be my first time to see the movie, and I've heard it's fantastic.
Yeah.
Yes.
And I think some semblance of us are going to be there as well. So we'd love to have you
better.
All.
Yes.
You do not have to pay anything. It's free. But I'm told you will get escorted out by Lionsgate if you pull out your phone during the screen. They don't like that. Look, we've been telling this story, like Luke said, since the beginning of our time as musicians. And it's been something that we both, obviously, in sort of an act of paying it forward, we share about Compassion International and ask people to reach out around the world and impact kids around the world through compassion. And Luke was the one that came up with the idea in 2020. He was like, hey, we should turn this into a film. And it's been taking 4 years to kind of develop a lot of twists and turns along the way, as you can imagine, and a lot of twists and turns in even making a film about your family. And both my parents are still very much alive and well, and that even presents, with all due respect, its own problems, because you need to be able to tell. We didn't want this to be a glory project. You have the Hallmark Channel. They're doing a good job on their own. We did not want to make a Hallmark film. We wanted to make a grounded drama adventure about what we, experienced as kids coming to the States, told through the lens of our mum. And so it always, funny enough, with playing dad specifically, it was always just kind of, that was the one bit that I was like, I think I should do this. We didn't know about me directing it or even co-writing it initially, but I was like, I just think there's something really, I know the guy so well, and we've spent, he also is the third silent member of For King Country, and so it felt very natural. And in all jokes aside, I'll say this, by confession, I've often been very lazy with my parents' story, in that I've just gone like, I don't know why they act the way they are. Like, I don't know, why they think the way they think or why they act the way they act. And there was something about, in the end, writing and directing and dropping into the 90s, dropping into that time, dropping into their life, dropping into the fact that being a father with six kids and one on the way and no insurance and no food and no way to get home and no tickets, like what the stress and the strain would have been and the amount of empathy that's given me for my dad, for my mom, has been really deep. So we're really proud of it and excited to show it to you all tonight.
Well, I can't wait to see it at 5 o'clock in Shamblin. As you know, I'm a big fan of what you do. I was there for your showcase at the Exit Inn. That might have been the first show you ever did.
Oh my goodness, that's crazy.
And that song, Love Me Like I Am, I was back there, and that song is so emotional. Like, I started tearing up, and then my nose started running, and I think, I don't have a Kleenex, so I'm running backstage trying to find a Kleenex, because I love that song so much. So can you maybe do one more song for us? Is that...
Oh, we can. And I will say this before we do. Is that okay if we do one more song? I don't know. All right. The film comes out on the 26th of April, which actually happens to be our parents' 49th wedding anniversary. Yeah, Lionsgate picked the date, and we had forgotten and that it was our parents' anniversary. A week later, we were on the phone with Mum. We said, hey, they've picked the date. It's April 26th. And she said, oh, that's our 49th wedding anniversary, right?
She sounds exactly like that, actually. Yeah.
To which we replied, yes. That's why we did it, Mum. And I did the math, because films, as you know, release on Fridays. And a Friday only takes place on the 26th of April.
Speaking of research.
This is good research, by the way. Every... 7 years, and so that means it's a 2,555-to-1 chance that would actually take place. And so this is a film of miracles. You see them on screen, but there were so many behind the screen. And so we encourage you to, if come to the film, if you enjoy the film, guys, you are a powerful bunch. Please share about it. With music, you have years to promote an album. With a movie in theaters, you have one weekend. To really build the story. And so we encourage you to do all you can. We're dubbing you our unsung hero ambassadors at Lipscomb University. And we'll play one more song. Do you want to join
Fantastic.
Us for this one?
Or no, I'm good. I'm okay. Going to step on the side. Joel and Luke for King and Country.
All right. Let me see you back up on your feet now that you've rested. And before we finish up, we should introduce you to the lady and gentleman up here on stage. His wife and two children are actually here this morning on the acoustic guitar, rather. This is Daniel Waterbury, everyone. Give him a cheer. And up the back from the country of Texas, y'all. This is Vincent DiCarlo right here. He's vintage. Who we got over there, little brother?
Over playing the piano here, we have a man who hails from the great city of Miami, folks. Would you give it up for our man, Mr. D-Lo, Daniel Lopez?
And our fearless band leader. He did go to a rival college, Belmont, but we won't hold that against him. All right, looks like you're out, man. He's a great chap. He's a man of threes. He's a number three on the Enneagram, just like me. Three names, Garrett P. Tyler, everyone.
And she represents all of the ladies here tonight, well, this morning, yes. And I have to say, sorry, I nearly destroyed her violin this morning, no joke. We gave her a little bit of a tap, and but she forgave me, thankfully. Also from the great school of Belmont. But these two are married, all right? So love
True
can
story.
Happen at a university,
they
folks.
Fell in love.
They fell in love. Would you give it up for Hannah Tyler, ladies and gentlemen?
Sing this.
Joy, joy.
Sing it out.
Joy, joy.
Three-part harmony. What did you think, little brother?
I think they're singing better than we are this morning.
This song has a very sophisticated, unexpected title you're never going to see coming. It's called Joy. Whoa! Whoa! Yeah!
Lately I've been really watching the nightly news. Can't seem to find the rhythm. Just wanna sing the blues. Feels like a song that never stops. Feels like it's never gonna. I gotta get that fire back in my bones.
You can put your hands together.
Before my heart turns into stone. So somebody please pass the megaphone. I'll shout it on the count of three.
Shout with me.
One, two, three. Oh, in my prayer tonight. I'm singing to the sky. Give me strength to raise my voice, let me testify. Worship my prayer tonight, cause this is do or die. The time has come to make
sing out.
And I choose.
Hey, stop. You guys feeling it? All right.
Feels like it's never gonna.
Gotta get that five. I think you can move a little bit then.
Before my heart turns into stone. So somebody please pass me the megaphone. I'll shout it on the count of three. Count with me. One, two, three. Pushing my prayer tonight. I'm singing. The sky, give me strength to raise my voice. Let me testify. Oh, hear my prayer this morning. This is do or die. The time has come to me.
And Lipscomb chooses
joy. Let it move. Let it move. Let it move. Yeah, we choose joy. Let it move. Let it move. Let it move.
Sunday school.
Down in my heart to stay. I need the joy. Down in my heart. Down in my heart.
If you believe it, sing it out. I need the joy.
That's right. Come on.
Down in my heart. One more time with a bit of fiesta vibe. I need the joy.
Lipscomb, everybody with me. Come on. Get low. Get low. How low can you go? Get low. Then on the count of three, I want to see you jumping. One, two, three,
let's
jump.
Go.
Want to let it go?
Let's go, come on.
One more time for the boy.
I need the joy, 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 joy down in my heart. Down in my heart to stay.
May we take that joy to Lipscomb, to Nashville, to Tennessee, the United States, and the world. Hey, lovely to be with you once again. We'll see you tonight.
Let's give it up one more time for King and Country. Such a gift to have him with us. We'll see you tonight at 5 o'clock in Shamlin. Have a great rest of your week. Go in peace, my friends.